It's so good to see you all, masks and all. As John said, my name is Nicole Sweeney, host of Evening Jazz. I'm with you Monday through Thursday from 8 until 1 a.m. It's truly one of my favorite places to be. You and the music, I tell you, it's what has kept so much of us going, right? We're in for a treat. Someone said to me tonight, this is the hottest ticket in town, okay? Aww. I know that's right. I drove about 2 hours, dropped the little one off, and couldn't wait to get here because this is truly the hottest ticket.
Thank you.
Matthew Whitaker.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
Can I tell you something?
What?
On the way here, I heard, because I was listening to the station, WBGO. Not because
yes.
I work there, but I actually really enjoy being a listener.
Same.
And boy, they threw on this tune called Janine. Oh. But it was Janine with a Latin flow, and it was you.
Aww.
On this new album, Connections, I tell you, you're doing that and more with the music.
Thank you.
Talk to me about Connections. This was made, recorded during...
The pandemic,
The P word. I'm kind of tired of saying it. We're going to have to shorten that one.
Right. The pen.
The
right?
Pen.
The pen. No, but I think, Connections is really an album that focuses on the connections I have with other artists and their connections with me. And like I said, it was recorded this year in March. Derek Hodge was producing everything, and everything just went really smoothly. Everything just worked out. I had the band on here as well.
Right.
Yeah.
Everything fell into place the way that Connections do, right?
Yeah.
Now, talk to me about what it is about these artists that you felt a connection to and why it was important to have them on this album, especially during this time. I think during the pandemic, we all had to be very mindful of who we chose to spend time with, right? So the fact that you chose to spend it with some of these great musicians, talk to me about why.
Yeah, I mean, well, a lot of these musicians that are on this record, you know, have played a huge part in my career and in my life. And for example, Steve Oquendo, since you mentioned Janine, I'll start with him. He was my first band teacher at the Harlem School of the Arts. And he was the one who taught me all about Latin music and playing the piano in that style. And he also plays trumpet. And he also has his own group as well of musicians. And I said, hey, why not just feature them on that track? And I did the horn arrangements, but he also just helped me just expand it for his group, and it went great. And you know, there's so many other people, including John Baptiste, who I've met since I was 10 years old. I've met him a long time ago, and I also got a chance to meet India Owens and Negra Santos. They were both on the Stephen Colbert show, I had a chance to play keyboards on the show with them, and you know,
with
just people
up.
Like yeah, and yes, it's really just all about the connections, really. And you know, Regina Carter is on the album as well.
Yes,
and just so many other people.
It's a great album. Now I'm gonna get into the music, but my last question, because I was listening to the album, and I think one of the best tests to good music is you listen to a record in your car. If it doesn't sound good in the car, you know. It's a little iffy, but you throw on Connections in the car, you might miss an exit, all right? Now, I was listening, and I had on Spotify, and a song called Blue Rondo a la Turk came on, and I have to be very honest with you, I double-checked while I was driving, don't tell anyone, I double-checked my phone, because I said, did they just skip to the Dave Brubeck channel? Because I thought this was Matthew Whitaker, but it indeed was you. And I have to tell you, what he does with Blue Rondo a la Turk is something you have never heard before. It's Dave, but it's all you.
Yeah.
Talk to me about doing something by the great Dave Brubeck.
Yeah, that song, honestly, you know, I just remember hearing it, and I actually just decided just to arrange it, just to see what happened. You know, we were all in lockdowns and stuff like that, and I was like, yeah, why not? Why not? Just arrange it, see what happens. And I showed it to my piano teacher at Juilliard, and he was like, oh, great, you know? I think I showed it to Derek when we were figuring out what songs can go on the record, and he was like, yeah, let's do it, so.
Yes, you have taken a classic and have made it your very own classic. I love Blue Rondo Alla Turk. Yeah. It's actually
and we're
my
doing
favorite.
That song tonight, too.
It's actually
yeah.
one of my favorite Bubek tunes. Yeah. So
yeah. And we're doing that song tonight as well. So.
All right. Well, we know what we're here for, right? The music. Let's get into it. Please put your hands together for the Matthew Whitaker Quintet.
Thank you.
Thank y'all so much. Y'all doing good? Thank you. Thank y'all so much for tuning in, for coming out. Oh man, this is an amazing experience. Shout out to Yamaha as well. Shout out to y'all and WBGO. Yes. Love y'all so much. Oh man, that was a song written by the late, great Chicoria, which is Spain. And before that was an original song of mine called Journey Uptown. And next we're gonna do a song that was written by Dave Brubeck called Blue Rondo a la Turk. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Blue Rondo. Thank you. This next song we're doing is this is a song that was written by one of my mentors that recently passed away, Dr. Lonnie Smith. Yeah, and every time I go see him live, he always plays this song, and this is a song that he wrote. This is a song called Pilgrimage. Thank you. Thank y'all so much. On the tour, Montrose Robinson. Thank you guys. Wow. Woo, thank you. That was a song that I wrote that's also on the new record, Connections, called A New Day. This next one we're gonna do is a song that is written by Dave Whitaker, and this one is called The Garden Wall. Thank you. Thank you so much. This next song we're going to do is another one off of the new record. This one is a song I wrote during the pandemic. And this one is called Stop Fighting. And this is because of what has been happening and what is continuing to be happening all across the world, you know, as far as police brutality and bullying and just people being negative towards one another. You know, we don't need that. Just stop fighting. Stop fighting.
Thank you.
Thank y'all so much.
Keep it going, keep it going. Woo. All right, Matthew Whitaker, ladies and gentlemen. This is the hottest ticket, totally, for the entire 2021. Thank you for an amazing performance. I have to check my bank account because I should have paid about $400 to be here. Can you imagine?
Wow. Thank you.
Can I tell you something? Hello. You know, I tell you something, Matthew. I judge a show by looking around the room and seeing the reaction to the audience. There was a time where everyone in this place couldn't stop their heads from moving. Some of y'all had your eyes closed, but everybody was feeling the music and making what a connection. Connection
there it is.
Were made
there it is.
Tonight.
There it is. Connections. There it is.
All right. Now, as you can see, Matthew is not here alone. Marcos Robinson on the guitar, y'all. When you play it like that, you gotta call it a guitar, okay?
A guitar.
Oh, Marcos.
A guitar.
Also, Karim, am I saying that right? Yes, Karim Hutton on the bass. Yes, please give it up for Karim Hutton. Woo. Now let me move on over and give the drummer some. Isaiah Johnson. And I did not forget about this amazing sound coming over here. That hat, you gotta tell me where you got that hat from after the show, but please give it up for Ivan Yanis, did I say that right? On the percussion. This was truly an unforgettable performance. You know, Matthew, at one point you were playing Blue Rondo a la Turk, and I said to your manager, you know, most Deaf or Common can come out here and spit a verse and walk right off, and it would be flawless, because you really went from a jazz classic into something that I'm used to, you know, something that I think our generation connects to.
I was going for that vibe anyway.
You was going for it anyway?
Yeah.
I almost kicked a verse, you know. But I decided not to. How are you feeling, Matthew, about this album and what it's, you can feel it, can't you?
Yeah, I definitely feel it. And I just feel amazing that the fact that I was able to, just do what I, love to do and just have that being documented, via, an album is amazing. And the fact that, I was able to feature some of my favorite artists and also just write a lot of music that fit, like Stop Fighting or another song that I wrote, It Will Be Okay, which is also written during the pandemic, and and just stuff like that really just moves me, so I'm really grateful, and also the fact that you guys were supporting me is just
come on now, Matthew.
That's
without question.
Yeah,
you know, when I think of all of the music that you played tonight, Dave Brubeck, Chick Corea, Cannibal Adderley, with Janine and Duke Pearson that wrote that tune, and of course, the great, the good doctor.
Yes.
Lonnie Smith.
Yes.
Can I tell you something? There is a Yamaha up there in the sky, and all of those gentlemen are hanging out right now, and they saying to themselves, we did good. We did good. Matthew, thank you from me, someone who is of this generation. You know, Matthew's only 20 years old. He mentioned something about 10 years old, a long time ago when I was 10. That's like my four-year-old saying, when I was a baby. Really? Matthew's only 20 years young, and that felt good. There's so many different ages and walks of life in here, and that felt good.
Thank you.
Music should feel.
Thank
y'all
you.
Doing all right? Thank you so much for spending tonight with just great, great company. And there's one more song that we've got. I could talk to Matthew all day because he's got this infectious energy that you just don't find anywhere else. Matthew, thank you for being you.
Of course. Thank y'all for having me. Thank y'all for having me.
Yeah. And thank you to all of the WBGO supporters Woo! Out there, because without you, we can't do this. We yes. can't support artists like this. So thank you for what you do. All
thank
right?
Thank y'all.
We got one final song,
yeah.
right? We're going to get into a little holiday music, but I think if I know Matthew, he's going to put a Whitaker spin on it. Is that, can I call that a Whitaker spin? One more for Matthew Whitaker and his quintet, y'all.
That's right. That's the appropriate response.
Thank y'all so much. Woo! I love y'all. Yeah. I love y'all. Thank you so much. Happy holidays. Happy holidays.